Hello?
Okay.
Oh, I think we're good now.
I think so too.
Can you guys hear us all right? Uh-oh. Okay, I think we're good now.
Okay. Apologies, guys. We totally botched that.
I'm so sorry, you guys. Yeah, we botched that. Hi, Kyle. Hi, cynical artist. Hi, Victoria. Hi, Cass. We saw the message that your boss let you sneak out and see us. Probably a button under the audio. Yeah,
Yeah.
we
Well,
got it. We
yeah.
got it.
We
Yeah, you guys can hear us. We can lip read. All right,
Yay.
I'm gonna redo the intro. Hola, you amazing artist. There we are.
Hello. Hello to everyone. All of you people that we said hello to didn't hear us say hello to
I
you.
know. We said a
So,
whole bunch of hellos.
hello again.
It was like we were mimes. We were like.
I should keep a piece of paper on hand where we can write messages just in case that happens. Hi, Esther. Oh man.
Yeah, that was not our most finest intro moment into
Nay.
the live stream.
Nay.
Nay.
But we're here now. How are you guys doing?
Yeah, let us know how you guys are doing. We are doing pretty good,
Yeah.
all things considered. We've been spending a lot of time in the studio.
Yeah. I'm
I think
sure
we've
you're
all been
shocked.
spending a lot of time in the studio. Yeah.
Yeah, we've been working on audiobook commentary, and we've realized that because we both talk a lot, we get very inspired and we tangent on things, that the audiobook commentary is a behemoth.
Yeah, anybody that supported me on Indiegogo that got the audiobook commentary as the extra thing, you're gonna basically get another entire book because it's gonna be a lot of audio commentary and a lot of really cool stuff that we talked about that just I'm excited. I'm really excited about launching that later on this month.
Absolutely.
I
Hi,
Hey
Mario.
Mario, I thought maybe only the rogues can hear. I gotta pay for that.
Raffi and Klee trapped in
The
a screen,
screen, it's
very Twilight Zone
right? We were
special.
like, get it. We were actually like, help, help us.
What could be done with that for Halloween? It's better than the start to my first collab, so you're fine. Doing good, says Kyle. Good, Kyle.
Good, Kyle.
Kelly, I'm sitting playing with, as always, you guys, I'm sitting playing wildly with my computer, thinking it's my iPad. As always, you guys, the ticker tape moves fast and it gets temperamental if we try to scroll it back. So if we miss your question,
Just copy and paste.
copy and
Copy and
paste it.
paste as many times as you
Yeah,
need
and don't
to.
feel like you're bothering us by copying and pasting
Yep.
multiple times because you're not. Hi, Birdsong.
Georgia Davis Art said, I'm excited. I sold my first painting yesterday. Yay! Yes!
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Pauline says, I'm good, spending a lot of time in my studio. You guys keep me
Aw,
motivated.
thank you, Pauline.
Hi,
Thank you.
Megan. Zoe. Hi, I'm working on my first order for custom clothes. That's
Yes,
awesome,
Zoe, that's
Zoe.
awesome.
Sarah, someone trying to call me I don't want to talk to now. Tell them you're busy. Hi,
Hey,
Charity.
Charity.
So excited for the commentary, says Charity. We are having a blast with the
Yeah.
commentary. Ruby says, yes, I haven't made a live stream in a long
Yeah,
time.
exciting to have you here, Ruby.
Us too, Ruby. We missed last month. We're
Yeah, we
sorry,
did.
guys. We're glad to be back. We had so many things happening.
Dana said, I reloaded my page and checked my sound, thought it was me. Yeah, I'm sorry, you guys.
Sorry, guys. It's because I wore this t-shirt. It threw off
Yeah.
space time.
It's
It's
so
like
weird.
two can't exist in the same space, and it got rid of our
It's
sound.
so weird. It's so
Is
weird.
it freaking you
It
out?
is freaking me out. Gary, hi from Ireland. Hey,
Hi,
Gary.
Gary. Hi, Bead Mim. Hi, Shawan. Pauline said, Yippee, Zoe. That's so awesome,
Yeah.
Zoe. Samantha, hi, Rafi and Klee. So happy you liked my YouTube
Oh,
video.
absolutely, Samantha. Thank you for
Yeah.
sharing that with
Yeah,
me.
thank you. Brooke.
Brooke is
Hi,
here.
Brooke.
Hi, Brooke.
Congrats, Georgia, and hey, Rafi and Klee. Studio 13, howdy from Central Texas.
Howdy.
Hi, Andy Cat. Andy Cat says, love your portrait painting.
Thank you. Thank you. That was challenging. That was challenging. Hey, look, there she is back there.
Yeah.
I never know where I'm pointing.
When I know, everything's in reverse. That was an experiment in detail and a venture into open acrylics.
Yeah, I've never used open acrylics. For anybody that wants to know, because I got a few questions about open acrylics take a little bit longer to dry. They have a weird sticky consistency, though, because it is acrylic. And they're a little bit runny, but I like them just as their own medium. If you're considering getting open acrylics to replace oil, acrylic will never replace oil.
But it's its own thing.
But it's its own thing. And I would suggest experimenting and playing around with it because it was fun.
Tim said, first time live stream for me. This is awesome. Hey, Hi, Tim.
Tim is going to be making a debut in our first ever Zoom hangout video. We got to talk to Tim and
it was such a good conversation.
I think Tim might be a little bit nervous. I know that I am a little bit nervous about putting it out there because it's content that I've never done.
Yeah.
We're interviewing one of you amazing artists one on one.
I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. Yeah, the conversation was great. I think there was so much good stuff there.
Yeah, I think so too.
Hi, Shoopaloo.
Shoopaloo.
I see progress on your collab.
Yeah, it's getting there. It's getting there. It's going to be awesome.
Mine too. I haven't. We'll talk about that later.
Yeah.
Lena. Hey, awesome people. Hi, Lena.
Hi, Lena.
Shawan said the portrait came out beautiful.
Thank you. It really Shawan, did. Thank you.
It's a good portrait.
Thank you. I am proud of it. Like I said, it was a little touch and go there. I make it sound so dramatic. It was touch and go there for a little while, but it was just, it was challenging. It was a challenging project. That's one of the reasons I say take on challenging things, things that are going to be outside of your comfort zone, because when you do get it done, which eventually you will, you're going to feel like a badass. And I kind of feel like a badass right now.
Yeah, so, you fa-chunked the heck out of painting.
I did. I had to fa-chunk it because if not, I would not have gotten it done.
The cynical artist said romper room for artists. Mm-hmm. Andy Cat said it was so cool watching you work on it during the podcast.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. You know, it's funny because if you watch that, you could see all the different layers that I put under in order to get to where I wanted to get to. None of that was planned, you guys. That was all like, basically, that was me. And the light turned green, and then I closed my eyes and just...
screamed.
Yeah, hit the gas pedal and just went for it.
Janama said, what do you say to people who think that art is irrelevant, impractical, or just plain silly?
I tell them that they are irrelevant, impractical, or just plain silly.
I tell them that they should seriously go fly a kite. It might be good for them.
Yeah. There's a lot of people out there that they don't have that. In those moments, honestly, I get kind of like, I'm like, oh, okay, that's cool. So that means that you'd like to live in like a gray house that all looks the same and all the cars look the same.
There's art everywhere.
And there's no television shows or movies or music
or design
or different clothing. So yeah, absolutely. Art's irrelevant.
Yeah.
Idiot. Like that's basically where I go.
Charlie B said, hi guys. Hey Rafi, I just saw your painting in a movie, I think.
Oh, actually I do have a painting in a movie.
It's an indie movie.
It is.
There's a backstory to that, but perhaps it is the movie.
Maybe.
Cass, I sold two pieces on that online thing by the case, a print and a gouache.
Yes, Cass.
Did I say gouache correctly?
Gouache.
A gouache on canvas board. Congratulations, Cass.
Well, last time you called it guache.
Gouache.
Yeah, you said guache.
Did I?
Yes, you did.
I'm getting there with that word. Andy Cat, I have to tell you, you two are such a ray of sunshine in this crazy world.
Oh, thank you, Andy.
Thanks,
Cat.
Andy Cat. We, we have our ups and downs and good days and bad days, but we try to focus on the good.
Yeah, we all do. Basically, the way I actually wrote a blog about it on my website today where I was talking about positivity, like forced positivity. And I was like, you know, that's one thing that I never want to be. Like, I want to inspire people. But I don't want to go out there and pretend like, my shit doesn't stink sometimes, because sometimes it does.
Yeah. Kelly said, I just want to throw it out there that I love my bracelet, Klee. Oh, Kelly, that makes me so happy. Yeah, we were talking about that and how it's okay if you're not okay.
Yep.
You just gotta face it and go through the things and don't stuff the feelings down.
Exactly.
Freedom's Realm, by doing busy doing mock-ups, thanks so much for solving that problem. Oh. Happy to be here from Haida Gwaii, British Columbia.
Yep.
Cool.
Yeah, that the mock-ups program, that's I wanted to share it with you guys because that's the best one that I've found, and that's what I'm using. And the people from Canvy are really, really nice. Like, really nice.
Yeah. Lena said, I was very lucky to marry into an entire family of artists. We all get each other.
Yes, that's nice. Awesome.
Cass said, I can't pronounce it either.
It's guache.
I doubt it's guache.
I think we should all start calling it guache and see if, you know, and then criticize people that don't pronounce it like that.
Yeah, be those people. It's guache.
Yeah, it's guache.
Janama said, thanks, everyone. Cass said, it's my Worcestershire. Worcestershire. And I almost said Worcestershire. Pauline, what do you tell people you're an artist and their response is, do you have a job with a real skill set?
I've had people ask me like, well, what do you really do? And I'm like, I really am an artist.
We've decided that we're gonna start telling people that we have fun for a living. He's gonna say that, and then yep. I'm gonna say it's a lot to manage. Fortunately, we have protocols in place to help yes. organize our fun.
Yep.
And see what they think about that.
Yeah, and then just look at them really seriously.
Yeah. Tim said, read the blog and it was great, very well written too.
Oh, thank you, Tim.
John, I can't wait for my bracelet.
Yeah, exciting.
Your bracelet will be on its way very shortly. Abby said, learning how to do calligraphy and hand lettering, both digital and paper, definitely a learning curve being left-handed. Nothing is made for left-handers.
Yeah, yeah. Abby, I have, I'm sure you already saw it, but on the vlog channel, I've got that place that you could go to and you could actually make your calligraphy into a typeset. Like Clea and I on our computers, we have our own lettering as a typeset so that we can write things in our lettering because yeah. we're nerds.
Yeah, and it's cool. Hi from California. Do you believe in Sasquatch? Sasquatch. I see what you did there. Very good.
Hey, made it, Nadia. Hi, Nadia.
Hi, Nadia.
Yes, guache. Yes, Brooke. Let's just call it that and see what happens.
Yeah, guache. Hey,
you're a spy, said Mario. When they ask you, like, what do you do? Oh, really? I'm a spy.
And that's all I can say
hey,
about
it's
that.
Martin. Hi, Martin.
I just wanted to say it like, how are you doing? How's it going up there? How are you doing? How's it going up there?
I just tell people that I draw for a living, says Kelly. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I draw, you know, the way that we should respond for a lot of these, I think we should have fun because a lot of people just don't know how to respond to an artist when you tell them that you're an artist. So like do like in Forrest Gump, you know, and just start and I draw and I paint. And I like painting sometimes.
Sometimes I paint things that are red, and sometimes I paint things that are blue. Sometimes I paint big things, and sometimes I paint little things.
Yep. Just have fun with it.
Clover Artist said, I say I'm a very underpaid full-time artist. No pullback yet.
No pullback yet.
Victoria said, where can I find your blog?
Oh, the blog is on my website. So if you go to rafiandclee.com, you'll see an area on the top. I think it says blog. I don't know. I just changed the number. It'll either say subscribe or it'll say blog.
Mm-hmm. Tell haters to blow it out their barracks bag.
Their barracks bag.
Kelly said, hi. So happy the reminder bell actually worked.
Oh, well, we're happy to have you here, Kelly.
Yeah. Hi, Naomi and Wendy. Hi, guys. Sorry I'm late. It's okay. You're right on time.
It's okay. We didn't even have sound in the beginning.
Yeah,
so
we were just
fine.
Talking and no one could hear us. Stripey Sharpie said, yes, live stream. I've been hoping for one so I could have more audio to finish setting up my studio with. You guys helped me focus so much.
Oh, that's awesome.
Well, I'm glad we got our audio thing figured out.
Thank you for that.
Make guache great again.
Not guache, it's guache.
Make guache great again. Lol, yes. Jess said, I caught the live stream. Yay! Archiverts unite.
Archiverts unite.
Eb said, life is like a box of pastels.
Life is like a box of pastels.
Ray made it. Hi, beautiful people.
Hey,
Hi, Ray. Birdsong, I say I'm a drawer. Not to be confused with a drawer.
That's what you were trying to say. Like, I'm a drawer.
A drawer, not a drawer.
Ruby said, is it a bad idea to start an art business right now because of the virus and post office issues? Okay, so post office issues are definitely a pain in the butt.
Mm-hmm.
As far as starting a business right now, I think that a lot of things are changing in the direction. A lot of people are a little bit more reliant on technology. So Ruby, I would definitely not wait to start a business. Obviously, things are going to return to some semblance of normal.
Absolutely.
At some point. So you want to get started before that. Just get your feet wet doing what you're doing.
Right now we're having some postal hiccups, but things are getting to their destination safely, albeit late.
And hopefully that gets resolved.
Abby
we're not going to go into that.
Yeah. Abby said, it says blog.
Yeah, okay, thank awesome. Thank you, Abby.
Andy Cat said, do we all have our happy juice?
Yes.
I've got wine.
I've got happy juice.
Salute.
Salute. We true, I draw blood and pictures. I draw blood and pictures. I love that.
That's true, Kelly, and hilarious, and I never thought about that. Imaginary Eva said, y'all the bomb. Thanks for endless inspiration.
Aw, thank you. You're the bomb.
Yeah, and inspiring.
You just missed the mime show. Yeah.
Brooke said, I sold a piece to my doctor the other day, told her I was an artist, and she had questions and wanted to see pics. I was laying on the table. It got awkward, but still sold the piece.
Yes, Mark.
High five for handling that.
That's one of the reasons that I say, like, man, just talk to everyone. Let everyone know. A lot of us shy away from telling people because we're afraid that they're going to be like, so what do you really do? And really, those aren't going to be your customers, but you're going to have plenty of people that are going to be like, oh, that's cool. Is there any way I could see some of your art? So, like, yeah, that's awesome, Brooke. I love the awkward sale. That is definitely a good story that's going to, you know, be told in the future, I'm sure.
I love that. David said, I love the show, guys. I paint occasionally, but I'm a full-time photographer for a small newspaper, so that's my artistic outlet. Hopefully, I'll be painting again soon.
Yes, David.
Awesome all around, David.
You're doing it all around. That's awesome.
Sarah said, tomato soup.
Tomato soup.
Brooke said, I've got my happy juice, Andy. Cheers. Excellent.
Cheers, Brooke.
Cheers, Brooke. Samantha, when I was asked what I do and replied artist, she was okay with it. But when asked what type and I answered abstract expressionist, she looked blank.
Yeah, it's so funny. But think about my answer. When people ask me what type of art I do, I tell them Rafi art.
And they're like, I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that means. I'm like, well, it's my art.
Ev said, I made a great connection with a business today and became an affiliate and builder for their online and retail storefront. Business is still businessing.
Yes, they are.
Naomi says, tell him I finished my first commission and then immediately afterwards refused a request from some creep wanting me to draw some random girls nude.
Yes. Awesome, Naomi.
Well,
awesome.
Congratulations on finishing the commission and knowing where your boundaries are.
Yes, that is important. Very
Cheryl
important.
Cheryl Ann, hi from Canada. I have a... Oh, no, the ticker tape moved. But we have a...
What we get? Oh, John M.
John.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you think collectors really care about canvas depth? I love the look of 1.5 inch and they're almost twice as expensive. They don't. I've not ever found that collectors really care about it. Now, obviously, with thinner, I personally like thicker depth on canvas. So a lot of times I'll buy it and it just makes the piece more expensive.
Yeah. Some people say, ooh, I love that, but I've never seen anyone pass up a painting.
No, nobody's ever looked at one of my paintings and said,
it's
you know, I like
thin.
That. It's just too thin. Like,
plus, they
ever.
Can frame it with a thicker frame if
yeah,
they want to.
Exactly.
Cheryl Ann, hi from Canada. I have a question about audio hacks when making YouTube videos. I have zero budget and my videos take place outdoors, so my greatest challenge is sound. Word. I use my tablet and phone.
Okay,
outside
so
can be tricky.
There is these little Rode microphones that have the like poofy thing on it that usually
windscreen.
Windscreen. That's what I would recommend. Any kind of windscreen would be the best thing to use on an external microphone for that.
Smarty said, OMG, that happened to me. Had to show my work while getting a tattoo.
Yes,
That's
I love
awesome.
That. That's awesome.
Minis, I wear my art and get lots of questions.
Yes.
Also an excellent thing to do. Zoe, I'm doing my first craft show in November, and I'm not mad that there will probably be less people there than usual because it seems like a good chance to get my feet wet.
Absolutely. Totally. You know, you want to know something interesting is that a lot of times I would actually prefer for a show to be a little bit slower.
Yeah.
Because what happens is you get this weird phenomenon when there's a lot of people that, you're looking out there, it almost looks like cattle just pushing each other along.
Yeah, when there's too many people, it's almost like you can't even interact with them.
Yeah,
so a little bit quieter of a show gives you a chance to really talk to people.
Yeah, to really stop and talk to people because you're not so all over the place trying to answer so many questions.
Kelly said, how about you answer whatever I feel like painting?
Yeah. Yeah, I love that. Yeah. What kind of art do you do? Whatever art I feel like making.
And then you can follow it up with, I think I'll actually go home and paint you, and then see how they react to that. Sarah said, what is traverse reality? I would say it's to navigate your way through this thing that we're all collectively in.
Yep.
Samantha said, Kyle Wood Creations. I really like that. John said, thank you for the advice.
Did we miss Kyle's thing? Kyle, would you copy and paste that so we could see it again?
Yeah. Jess said, traverse reality is going on something soon in this studio. I love that. Put it on a business card.
Yeah.
Let's see. Andy said, I had more shows and festivals scheduled for 2020 than ever. All of them down the drain.
Andy, you know, I'm sorry about that. Mm-hmm. But obviously, it gives you time to maybe redo that kind of schedule for next year.
Also,
if you can.
I've talked to a lot of artists who are putting the work together. They're still getting ready for the shows, knowing that even though the shows aren't happening, they're setting themselves up to be ready when the shows come back online, if you will.
Yeah.
Then you'll be ready for it.
That's where I would say act as if whenever things got low for us, we actually made ourselves more busy, and it just kind of helped us get through any really hard times.
Yeah.
Adventure seeking artist. Hi.
Brooke said, tell them you want to paint them like one of your French girls.
Yep. I kind of paint everything. You know what? I think I'd like to paint you like one of my French girls. I like that.
What say you? Tara said, lagging behind. Hopefully we're not dropping frames. Shoop said, all of our shows got canceled this year, too.
Yeah, but you are doing your own stuff on Facebook Live. You actually inspired us. We're going to be doing a Facebook Live on September.
I believe it's the first day of autumn. It's the first day of autumn, isn't it?
No, I'm going to get it.
We should probably know when that is.
Yeah.
Yep.
It is the first day of autumn, September 22nd.
I thought so, Tara said. I am a meat popsicle. Nice quote from one of my favorite movies of all time.
Yep.
Abby said, so I'm sitting here staring back at my goggle, and I think I'm going to take a series of photos of him looking in awe at my work.
I love that, Abby. Share those with me.
Yes, please.
I actually created a goggles page on Twitter, and I meant to allow people to post on there. I'm really not great at social media, you guys.
We'll get there. The cynical artist said, what do you guys think about selling art prints at a festival?
Absolutely.
Have them, offer them. That'll help cover your show fees.
Anything that you have that is going to help you have prices that are across the board, I suggest just go for it. Just have fun with it.
Sarah Day said, hey guys, naughty YouTube did not notify me you guys were live.
Shame on YouTube.
Shoop said, I'm so excited for your show.
Yay! I know.
I'm scared.
Yeah, we're both scared because I'm like, how are we going to do this? I want to do something really fun and cool. So
yeah, it'll be fun. Yeah. I know it will. It'll be fun, bloops and all, or whatever, bloopers and mistakes. Mario, there are two Rafis looking back at me. Love the shirt, Glee. Thank you, Mario. I had to sport my Rafi shirt. He's my favorite.
Aw, thank you.
Let's see. Kelly said, right there with you, Andy. My solo reception was canceled, so no one came. I lost my place. I'm sorry. I lost my place. That's okay.
You're reading too slow.
Oh, man.
No one came to the gallery to see my stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I've got stuff all around town and like nothing is like I'm not relying on anything selling. If anything, I'm leaving my stuff out there just to like bring a little bit of happiness into people's lives as they're going out and doing things.
Mm-hmm. Lena said, I was able to do one experimental show last month and it turned out great. It was outdoors and everyone was masked. We're doing it again next month.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. There are a few shows that are taking place.
Yep. For a thicker looking canvas, you can nail cheap wood trim from the hardware store to the sides of the stretcher frame.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. True story. I actually, a lot of times I just build my own stretcher frame when I do bigger pieces, which is why all my bigger pieces will be about an inch and a half thick because I use the 2x2. And I just build my own stretcher frames with that.
So this is what Kyle had said. If they ask, what do you really do? I lost it. I say traverse reality and see what they come back with.
Yes, Kyle, that's brilliant. That's where the traversing reality came from.
Ev said, I'm challenging myself to make as many of you laugh out loud on Discord as possible. This is the way.
This is the way.
Shoop said, no editing that video, lol. Tara said, make it, they will come. Keep making, creating, and when things open up again, you will be ready.
Yes, exactly. Cass said,
I sell art prints like crazy at festivals and cons.
Yeah, that's why, man. Just whatever you have that you could really put out there for yourself, especially things that like you don't have to be in production mode creating a lot of pieces, anything that you have. Listen, people are going to appreciate it. And with prints especially, just think of prints as a gateway drug to your bigger pieces.
It's true. Adventure-seeking artist said the Rafi shirt is epic. Thank you. Most art festivals and markets have been canceled in my area, but local markets are slowly starting to open back up.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Jess said, we should host some kind of an Artrovert event when the plague dies down. It will be exceedingly both awkward and lucrative, right? Maybe?
Yes.
We are thinking about potential future things that we might do of that nature because it would be super cool.
It would be. One thing at a time, though. We're figuring things out. Mm-hmm. And obviously, the way that I usually think about things is in long-term plans. So we're figuring all that stuff out.
Indeed. Hi, Amberworks. She said, yay, I made it. Janama, Cass, how do you personally make prints? So you guys can talk about that amongst yourselves.
I can tell you how I personally make prints.
There's a video.
I print them out on an inkjet printer because gicle means inkjet.
And then you do a bunch of other stuff. Jacqueline said, I'm late. I'm late for a very important date. Love you guys. Hi, Jacqueline. Brooke said, lol, Vicky. Ev said, keep an eye out for my masked COVID ventriloquist puppet act.
We will keep an eye out for that.
We will definitely keep an eye out for that. Ray said, I'm thinking about doing a solo show from my lawn, social distance artworks, and a day of fun where I don't actually have to leave the house. Maybe we'll have cookies.
I love that. You know, I love think that too. There are people that have been doing like art, like setting art up in front of their houses just so that their neighbors could look at it because a lot of people are kind of cooped up.
Yeah.
And I think that that's brilliant. We did stuff like that. We would do what was called a yard and art sale, like where we did our sale and like if we had stuff that we wanted to get rid of, we'd get rid of stuff. They weren't big money makers, but we did get a lot of attention from those things.
And they were fun. Tim!
Tim! Oh, thank you, Tim!
Thank you so much! That's awesome. In case some of you guys are newly joining us, this is our super chat shout out bell.
Yeah.
For all you guys who are awesome enough to super chat us. Thank you so
much.
Thank
you, Tim.
Cheryl, I go through periods of feverish creative activity and periods of crickets. It used to annoy me, and now I figure it's just the way it is.
It is. It is just the way it is. Sometimes, you know, you need to retrim. That doesn't make any sense.
Recharge
at all.
Recharge the batteries. Reacclimate to, I don't know. Okay, Naomi called from work. What did I miss for the last 10 minutes? Silly antics.
Not much.
Jess said, this is the best time to play the long game.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, it is, Jess.
Indeed. We're doing stuff that we had been talking about doing, and now we're finally, like, doing the things.
And just getting ready. I mean, one of the really cool things about all of this that's been going on is that Clea and I have been spending a lot of time, because not that she doesn't spend time in the studio, but usually she was doing the market and doing things, and because of that,
pulled in different directions.
We are like doing the thing.
We're focused.
So
we're laser focused, you guys. Shawn said that's a great idea. She might hang some quilts out in the fall. That would be so cool.
That would be so cool, Shawn. I want to see pictures, you guys. If you guys do like cool stuff on your lawn, send me pictures.
Please,
I want to see it.
Please share any innovative, cool things that you do.
And you can share it with us on Twitter, I think would be the easiest place. Obviously, for our patrons, just share it with me on Patreon.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I love that stuff. Just share it with me.
Cass said, if it's a digital artwork, I just print it. I have two Canon Pro 100s, prints of my paintings. I photograph and then print them. My dad helps.
Yeah. Yeah, the Canon, the Canon, like if you, it make sure that it's an inkjet. You don't want to have a laser jet printer. But really, the quality with the inkjets is great. The only reason I go to the printer to get bigger pieces printed is because my printer could only print up to 11 by 14.
Mm-hmm. Samantha said, I need to do a textile art experiment with Sherry as my main inspiration. Do you think it'll work? Lol, it didn't work so well when I tried this whilst knitting. Mm. You never know until you go for it.
Yes, you never know.
Tim said, will you please briefly comment on how you feel about copyright registration for visual arts? Do you recommend it for rogue artists? I know it can be an ugly part of the business. Thank you.
You know what? That's honestly, Tim, that's a personal decision. I don't really do. I've not really ever registered anything via copyright because I don't really have stuff that people might copy. The only thing might be like my T-shirts, but even then... it's copyright registration is really a personal thing. I did a video on it, Tim. There is a video out there that kind of explains my perspective on that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it just, I've never found the need to do it. If I ever had something that was super popular and I was worried about somebody, stealing it and doing prints of my work, which A, you could always contact them and do a cease and desist. But it's something that I've never allowed myself to stop doing what I do because of it. Do I recommend that you don't do it? No. Do I recommend that you do it? No. I mean, it's really up to you.
Yeah, absolutely. It is a personal choice. A lot of artists rely on like the common law copyright, where if you can show that you created it this date, then you're good. Esther!
Oh, thank you, Esther.
Thank you so much, Esther. Esther said you guys are so supportive. Here's some back.
Thanks
so much. You guys are the best to us. Abby, I've been having to recharge from the chaos that is my parents' household. Tried working day after I got back home. Brain said, nope. Lounge for a couple days. Motivation came back full force.
Yeah, there are times where I need to like step back. And usually those days are the days where I like do very, very little or nothing at all.
Mm-hmm. And it's good sometimes to announce it. Like today, Rafi was like, I don't know if I'm going to do all the things that I said I was going to do. I may do some.
Yep.
And I was like, that sounds like a fine plan.
Cass said, the Canon Pro 100 allows me to print up to 13 by 9 borderless if needed. Yeah, that the Canon Pro is perfect. I love Canon. I love Canon printers.
Yeah.
And that's great.
They make good things. Tim said, I will check out the video. Thank you.
Absolutely, Tim. Yeah, Tim, it's something that back in the day, it used to stop me. Like, I'd worry about copyright. I worry about people stealing my stuff. And then I was all weird about showing my stuff or posting my stuff online. And what I realized was that it was just hindering me. If there was ever a situation where I had like something that was maybe valued at like 10 grand and I was selling hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of it, then maybe I would do a copyright with that. But really with the pieces that I have now, I don't worry about it too much.
The book is copywritten, obviously.
Yeah, the book is copywritten. Like things like that are copywritten.
Yeah, case by case. Robert Vaughn said, hello, Rafi and Klee. Great to see you.
Robert.
Hi, Robert. Sarah said, I need a video on how to set up a website.
No, Sarah.
You know there are like 100 million videos
Sarah,
on
I am
YouTube.
Not a website builder. Go on YouTube and look up the millions of websites.
They'll do a lot better
things.
Job than
yes.
we would
yeah.
on website building videos.
It's not going
to
be good.
Corey said, hey, you guys, I'm a recent subscriber to the channel and I've binge watched a lot of your videos and I love it. 100.
Thank you.
Question for you both. If you could have one superpower, what would it be and why? Okay, I'm totally torn between teleportation or being able to understand and speak every language on Earth.
I would probably go with teleportation or flight.
Sure, flight's good too. I would love to
soar through the sky.
Yeah, yeah, all those things are really good.
Oh, you know what? Another superpower would be the ability to see all the colors in the spectrum.
Oh, the full spectrum. That's a good one too.
That would be amazing.
Yeah, that is really good. The Clover Artist. I'm making my commission sheet for my socials and my website. I hope I get a 3D commission soon. They are so fun.
That's awesome.
You're doing awesome, yeah, Clover. Yeah,
you are.
Let's see. Anna. Hola, I'm so happy I was able to join you. I was wondering what happened with the Van Life Project. Are you still going to do it?
Hi, well, Anna. Hi, yeah. Anna. So, like, that's part of our long-term plan, because originally I had said that maybe we were going to make a change in March, mm-hmm. and it's something that we're still thinking about. We definitely want to do traveling, but we've also been thinking about the fact that we do run an art business, and so we're measuring things out to see if maybe we get a small plot of land and get our truck to be able to travel.
Like with a home base studio. Of operation to come back to and work from, and then like a way of traveling.
Yeah, the main thing is that there is going to, you know, COVID pending, there's going to be changes that will happen in March.
Mm-hmm. Kelly said Canon Pro 100 printer is sold out in all the Best Buys in my area. I'm not paying $300 more for the same thing on Amazon. Yeah, I don't blame you, Kelly. It's probably worth waiting it out.
I would definitely wait it out.
Let's see.
What does this one say here?
Hi, thank you so much for checking out my Instagram and becoming my first follower. Lol, you absolutely made my day.
Oh, absolutely. Your stuff is amazing.
Victoria said, what are your thoughts on entering competitions? You've done it.
Yeah. Yeah. Actually, did I do a video or was that in the commentary in the book?
I think it was in the commentary.
So I used to be afraid of entering competitions because I was always worried that like, oh, I'm going to whatever. The only thing I say is like, take a look at the competition and make sure that it's not like a super scam. Like they're trying to take your money.
Yeah. Like a lot of monies.
But winning a prize or not winning a prize, like just entering it just for fun. There's a lot of competitions that you could do that are very, very cheap. Or they're not any money at all. And what I would say is if you're going to do it for fun, do it for fun. And that way you've got extra cool stuff that you could add to your resume. If not, you don't need to. Alaska!
Alaska!
Thank you!
Thank you! Cass said my superpower is currently sleep.
Yes!
Yeah.
That's Klee's superpower.
The sleep
too.
Is strong with this one, yeah. Also, Samantha said, I found you guys a couple weeks ago and did the same with binge watching. I've been binge watched you and Ask a Mortician, another awesome YouTube channel. Oh, the fun of living art and dark things. Brooke said, due to COVID, my superpower is about to be being a third grade teacher. Have you all seen how they teach math now?
No.
I have heard tell of how they teach math now, and I don't, my brain just doesn't want to investigate further.
Yeah. Oh, John.
John!
Thank you, John!
Thank you! Your videos inspired me to finally start making abstract art. It really helps me escape from the stress of pharmacy school. I hope to start learning to draw when I finish. Only 4 years left.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. That's awesome, John.
Yeah, it is.
Abstract, you know what? And it's such a cool thing, because if you really learn how to play and mix the mediums together, and when you start really fine-tuning your drawing and you're able to mix both of those together, that's the way that people find their voice.
Ray!
Oh, thank you, Ray!
Thank you guys so much. Aww. She said, you are both super inspirational. Your stubbornness and unwillingness to give up is infectious. Thank you.
I do have an art career because I am stubborn.
Doggedly persistent, stupidly hopeful.
Yeah, that's definitely a good way to describe me. Mm-hmm. Let's see, I'm going to go up here because I think we missed. I booked a solo show. Did we? Yeah.
Booked a solo show at a popular restaurant, both in seating and their takeout area. When they buy a dinner, they get a free Christmas art card. I figure no matter what, there will be Christmas.
Oh, that's brilliant. I love that. Yes.
Yeah, that's great.
In fact, that was something I haven't had the chance to put that in any of the videos that I've got ready to list. But one of the things I wanted to say, right now is the time to start getting ready for Christmas.
Mm-hmm. The sooner the better.
Yep. I so wish that Travco I showed you
would have worked. My mom and I were daydreaming, and I think we were like planned out your entire living space in Mobile Art Studio.
Yeah, I know, I know.
And you are so awesome for thinking of us in that way, Abby. We truly appreciate
it. Yeah, we do. We really do.
Shoop said, did you guys get your package?
Yes.
Yes. Yes,
so
we did.
Right now, because we are really, really bad at receiving stuff.
We do suck at it.
Man, we really do suck at it. Because, like, we had the P.O. box and, like, people have sent us, like, gifts and stuff like that. The plan is to open those things up
on camera. So we can shout out you guys and promote what you do.
Yeah. So
we have a pile.
Right now we have a pile, and we're planning on filming that at least this
weekend
and then launching it on the vlog channel next week. But yeah, we got it, and I am dying to open that package.
We can't wait to open it. Yeah, it will be like Christmas for us.
Yeah, we've got the book from Kyle too. We will be doing that soon.
And we have Esther's art too.
Yes.
We have so many things to open. Clover said, I would have selective mind reading that allows
teleportation. Yes.
That's pretty good, too.
Slowing down time, too, is one. Man, I would have all
you
kinds of superpowers.
You already do that. You already have that superpower. I'm behind on Halloween. Halloween always creeps up on me, and it's one of my favorite holidays.
We've wanted to do this thing where we collect videos from, like, all you guys doing the Boogeyman Boogie. The Boogeyman Boogie is this weird song that we did.
Yeah.
And I wanted to put a compilation video of all these artists all around the world doing the Boogeyman Boogie, and it always sneaks up on us.
You know what, though? Maybe we could do it this year. Maybe we can.
Maybe.
Robert said, I'm the featured artist at my local art gallery. Thank you for your advice and pushing me to put myself out there.
Yes, Robert, that's awesome.
Yeah,
awesome.
And remember, like, you're the one who chose to do it, so high fives to you. Big high fives. Jess said, so I don't trust YouTube with my money, but I found the Patreon and I'm poor, but I'm an annual patron now.
Oh, thank you, Jess.
Thank you, Jess. That's awesome. Samantha said, I prefer Halloween over Christmas. Halloween is my Christmas. Just need to get presents on Halloween.
Halloween is so much fun.
Halloween presents should be a thing. Shoop said, okay, awesome. Dana said, you have a package from me coming Friday.
Aww.
Thank you for letting us know, Dana.
Yeah.
We will keep an eye out for it.
Yep.
Charity said, you guys are number one YouTube, and Ask a Mortician is number two. She is awesome. Caitlin is fun to watch. I'm going to have to check this out.
Yeah, we're definitely going to have to check that out.
Sounds awesome. Samantha, I love Halloween too. Same fave holiday. It's so great. Halloween.
We love Halloween. Love Halloween. The encouraging artist. Aww.
Ayana Willa, hi.
Thank you, Ayana.
Love bombing just because y'all are awesome. Aww. We love you too.
Yeah, we love
And thank you for the love bombing on the social media and here.
Yes.
You are amazing.
Yes.
Jess said, smiling awkwardly into phone. Oh, we're kindred spirits in that way.
Yes.
Rafi looks over and watches me smile awkwardly at my phone all the time when I'm texting or checking emails. Mm-hmm. It's true.
Yeah, Halloween. Halloween is a great month to, like, get ready and do something fun and creative.
Mm-hmm.
It's not necessarily a month where, like, I've sold a lot of things, unless you do, like, Halloween themed stuff, which I would recommend doing if you have if you have that love for Halloween. But it's also a month to get really, really creative and do something fun, either on the outside of your house or on your person, to really, really show the world that you are an artiste of all kinds.
Indeed. Megan said she would remind us about Boogeyman Boogie. Thank you.
Thank you, Megan.
Appreciate it. I'm actually going to write Boogeyman Boogie. We're going to schedule this. We're going to make this happen. Even if it's like a soft launch of Boogeyman Boogie.
It is so ridiculous. I'm going to have to post something about the Boogeyman Boogie
soon. I have some ideas.
Yeah.
Okay. Brooke.
Oh, thank you, Brooke. I couldn't have done it without you. Oh, thank you, Brooke.
Brooke,
you're so freaking awesome.
I'm pretty sure you could do anything.
Yes.
But thank you for saying that. We're inspired by you also. Thomas!
Thomas! You guys created a great community. Be groovy. Thank you, Thomas.
Thank you, Thomas. Dudes and dudettes, you guys, I don't even know. Thank you.
So I sent Brooke an email because I want to interview her on
our
channel, because Brooke is amazing.
Yeah, she's super cool.
And I think you guys would really, really get a kick out of her perspective and stuff.
Yeah. Ev said, Thomas, you rock. I concur. Thomas, you do rock, yes. As do you, Ev. Andy Cat, have any of you Halloweenies seen Dr. Sleep, the sequel to The Shining?
Not yet. We usually save movies like that for Halloween.
We
spend our Halloween watching scary movies.
I do love Clover said, I use Halloween as a chance to get over the top clothing I actually want to wear every day. Yes. I feel you.
Yes.
Laska said, we are all a-goggling you too. You are awesome. P.S. I'll boogie.
Oh, sweet.
I know so many of you guys would boogeyman boogie it up so awesomely, and you would have your own versions of it, and it would be so much fun.
The problem is, you know what? We will do it, because the last time that I put out the Boogeyman Boogie video, we had maybe 100 subscribers, and I was just asking way too much of only 100 people. And we're going to do it. We're going to do it. It'll be fun. We could do this video of people Boogeyman Boogieing for Halloween.
Yes, indeed.
In your favorite costume outfits or whatever it is that you create.
Ray asked, did you get the Excalibur letter opener I sent you? That must be in the pile of things.
It's probably in the pile. We'll be opening it this weekend.
That's so exciting.
It's so bad. We have stuff from December that we haven't opened because we've been busy. But yeah.
Thank you, Ray. I did not know you sent it. Well, it's in there. It's in pile.
It was mentioned. It's mine. It's mine. My Excalibur.
Not if you can't pull it from the stone.
<It's so laughs>
what
mean.
If it's me? What if I'm the chosen one? John said that bell is getting a workout. Yeah, it sure is.
It is. I appreciate it, you guys, so much. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, guys. Zoe said, I ordered all of my Halloween charms for jewelry this morning, and I'm so excited to get them.
Oh, that is so cool.
I love Halloween jewelry. Spooky. Spooky and cute. Thomas said, Ev, I'm totally humbled with these folks.
Thomas, you are amazing.
Yeah. Enough said.
Yeah.
You know.
Ev,
you know.
You are amazing.
Yeah.
Enough
you know.
Said.
Yeah. Jess said, soft launch of the Boogeyman Boogie is my favorite quote of the day. Let's see. Are there any other Deathlings here? If so, hello, fellow Deathlings. This is one that I have not heard of also. In our town we call home, everyone hail to the pumpkin song.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
In this town, don't we love
That's
it
That's part of our repertoire in the studio when we're listening to, because we'll usually listen to movie scores, mm-hmm. and we definitely have Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh, yeah, we rock some Nightmare for sure. Anna, you guys are so awesome and help me to keep positive that I now feel strong enough to support others. I'm encouraging my son to take risks and start his channel.
Yeah, that would be awesome, Anna. And make sure that you share any information with us when he gets his channel started. I am all about supporting anybody who's doing something that is outside of the norm. I will support you all the way, especially if you are out there spreading just empowerment, happiness, fun, joy, weird.
Whatever.
Any
super
of that
awesome,
stuff.
Unique
yeah.
things that are unique to you.
Yeah.
Kelly said, did anyone hear the COVID mask song set to the Monster Mash theme? No.
No.
Kelly, you're going to have to tell us, or
yep.
we'll have to Google
it. Yeah, we'll Google it. We'll
Ruby,
Google it.
We watch Trick or Treat every Halloween as a tradition.
Trick or Treat.
I love Halloween traditions. Jess said, I'm a Deathling and a Murderino. These are terms that I am unfamiliar with.
Clee, you're so old.
I'm out of the loop. Kyle said, one year I made a puppet to answer the door. It scared the crap out of these kids. Fail or success? Trick. That's a success.
That is so cool. Oh, that is so cool. I love that.
Yeah, that's awesome. Clover said, my Halloween jewelry
is
my
regular jewelry.
Mm-hmm. No problem with that. Let's see. Kate. Casey said, I love y'all.
Aw, we love you.
Brooke said, yes, I would be honored. I think I missed the email. I'll get in touch. And hell yeah to the Nightmare Before Christmas.
Right!
Excellent
so
on all points.
Halloween.
Halloween.
I am looking for an alternative to deviant art. I sculpt in steel and I'm having trouble finding a good digital venue. So the last time that I used DeviantArt was like 20 years ago before I was even, really, really pursuing art as a career. I was still in corporate. And DeviantArt is a great place to maybe get your stuff out there. But as far as like having your own thing for digital, like a digital art venue, I really do recommend
having your own website.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, now that's my opinion. I'm sure somebody on here will have a much better answer
than
I do.
Throw your thoughts out there. Natalie said, hello from Mexico. I love watching your videos. Your optimism is contagious.
Aw, thank you, Natalie.
Samantha said, Deathlings are fans of Caitlin. Ask a mortician.
Okay. Awesome.
Thank you for telling us
We
that.
May become... We Deathlings may become Deathlings, well. Yes.
Jess said, Klee, you have to listen to a podcast called My Favorite Murder. You can thank me later. Thank you, Jess. Sarah said, I'm finally almost finished with Doggy. Been working on for 3 months. I've been out of it that...
You got it.
You do. Clover said, Twitter instead of DeviantArt.
Yeah, Twitter. That's a great suggestion.
Indeed. There's also a portfolio website I always forget about. Lena said, I love Mad Monster Party.
So helpful.
I don't know. Lena said, I love Mad Monster Party. I like to dress up as Little Tibia from the Skeleton Band. Let's see. So Samantha said, I'm going to check that out. Yeah, sorry. I spaced out there for a second.
Yeah, like,
didn't mean to leave you hanging.
There's this portfolio website, and I don't remember what it is. That's like the worst advice.
No, I was reading. Oh. I wasn't saying. Oh, my God. No, that was it.
No.
Clover, if you think of what it is, let us know. Even if it's later on.
Website I always forget about. There is, you know what, Clover? The thing is that there's a portfolio website that I have here somewhere that I'm like, what is it? So the only thing I can think of is...
The portfolio website that no one can remember.
Yeah. I would say Instagram too would be a good place to share your work.
Yeah.
Just any of the social media would probably get a little bit more traffic than DeviantArt. I feel like DeviantArt just kind of is this thing that's coasted along for a long time. So
it's true. Yeah. Using social media to drive traffic to your personal website is how we roll. Let's see here. Enjoying the
Behance is really good.
Behance?
Yeah.
Oh, is that a platform?
Yes.
Martin said, enjoying the Rogue Artist audiobook. Love all the S-bombs, keeping it real.
Thank you, Martin. We're listening to the Rogue Artist audiobook, right? And
as we're doing commentary.
As we're doing the commentary, we're listening to chapters and then sitting down and doing commentary. And what I realized was that when I lost, I don't know if you guys know, but I lost like 100 pages worth of audio. And then as I was putting things together, there's actually 3 chapters that kind of repeat. It's this weird thing where they repeat in on themselves. Mm-hmm. And immediately my insecurities just flared up. And I was like, oh, my goodness, everybody's going to. And of course, once you put an audiobook out there, you can't.
An audiobook is forever.
Yeah, an audiobook is forever.
I said, maybe we just need to hear those things twice.
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping for. That's what I'm hoping for.
It's fine.
Oh, look, Megan, Jess, Pixaset.
Weebly, Sendo.
Yeah, Weebly, Sendo.
Behave.
Yeah, awesome. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that.
I've said there are sites like Saatchi Online and a few
Saatchi
of their competitors.
Online.
They may be options if you're interested in that path. Like, the platforms. You did Saatchi Art for a while, did you not?
I did. I still have stuff on there. They got annoying to me, though.
Why? Just because?
Yeah, they kept telling me to, like, I needed to update my stuff.
Oh. So. Megan said Behance.
Behance.
The name of it.
Behance.
Oh, that rings a bell.
Yes.
That does ring a bell. Stutley Constable, I was looking at MyFolio and Behance, also seriously considering Etsy.
MyFolio. Etsy, if you're selling stuff, I still, you know, like, we've got our just a little bit of stuff on Etsy at this point because mostly we're focused on our website. Actually, we're not focused on Etsy at all, but when we do sell something, that's when we focus on something.
Yeah.
But Etsy is still, it's a good place to get your feet wet because at least that way, you know, you get to learn how to navigate when you do set up your own shop. So
it's a good starting point. It's just not a good long-term thing.
Yeah, I don't want to send people to Etsy without the disclaimer of like, always be ready to move on
to your own thing.
You know, or at least get yourself ready. Just use that Etsy as a stepping stone to the next thing.
McQueen said, doggone it, I missed the live.
Aww.
Well, we still have approximately 6 minutes yes. of live stream, so you're here.
Yeah, you're here. You made it.
Clover said, there's a huge list of portfolio websites, but still not the one I was looking for. You'll think of it at like 4 a.m.
I think she's right, because I'm still like, there's something on the tip of my tongue, and I'm like, what is it?
Karen said, no biggie. People will just fast forward thinking their player messed up.
Thank you, Karen.
That's probably true.
Thank you.
Naomi and Wendy.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much. Awesome. Thank you. Kyle said, I really enjoyed the book as the audiobook. The repeat is just an artistic emphasis on the importance. And we all make mistakes, too.
I know. I love it. I kind of wish that I had... Well, I do have a chapter on We Make Mistakes, but I really wish that the chapter that did repeat was the chapter on We Make Mistakes.
Yeah. Oh, that would be so brilliant. Great. Samantha said, just wondering what you use for editing your videos. I want to make better videos for my YouTube channel.
So I use... Sony Vegas, but Samantha, the only reason I use Sony Vegas, and I just did a video on this actually on the channel on our equipment and stuff, is because that's when I started doing videos with my kids a long time ago, and I had like the old camera, and this is where like a video took 7 hours to render. I bought Vegas, and that's what I got used to, and it used to be Sony Vegas. It is now sold by Magix, and I got it for about $65 on Humble Bundle. So every once in a while, just look and see if you can find a good deal, because typically it's like $300 or something like that, but you can find it. It's really easy to use, but there's so many editing programs out there that I haven't used that are probably even better and way cheaper or even free.
But I can tell you that watching him sometimes, I think for like, it's a very intuitive video editing program. Like I can understand mm-hmm. what's happening there. Amberwork said, is the portfolio website ArtStation?
ArtStation. That might be it.
Go Imagine, Susan said, Go Imagine is a new alternative to Etsy. They give 100% profits to children's charities. And they went live yesterday from beta.
Oh, that's awesome. Cool. Thank you, Susan.
Thank you for sharing that.
We'll have to check that out. Yeah.
Stutley said, you guys are great. Thanks to everyone in the chat, too. Oh,
thank you. Thank you for being here.
The Cynical Artist, what do you think of Store Envy? I have no experience with Store Envy.
I have not used Store Envy yet. I would have to ask other people that have used it.
Feel free to weigh in, guys, if you've used Store Envy. Mario!
Oh, thank you, Mario.
Mario and
Thanks
Cass.
For supporting my little artist.
Oh,
your
we
little
love you
artist
guys.
Is amazing.
Yeah, she's
amazing.
She's doing amazing things. Ev said, actually, that's what I thought happened when I listened to it. I thought it was my player. Hilarious. Way better than my version, which would have been full of every other sentence.
Oh, thank you, Ev. Thank you, Ev.
Yeah, this one was facepalming a little bit, but I think he's okay now.
I was, you know, because whenever you do something like that where you make a mistake and you put it out there, it's funny when it comes to the book, there's still so many insecurities that a lot of times what happens is I get this image of somebody just standing in front of me just screaming like, you suck!
You have failed this city!
Yeah, and I'm like, wait a second, what if somebody did do that? I'd be like, so what? Get
it's
out of
okay.
here.
Yeah. Yeah. Totally okay. Clover said DaVinci Resolve is beta that's free. I think as an editing thingy.
Oh, DaVinci Resolve. Yes, 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 yes.
Shoop.
Shoop. Oh, thank you. Don't forget to tip your server serving up awesomeness. Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Shoop. We love you. SS said, I still like using the State Fair for selling all my art. I don't sell a lot of it, but 2 years ago, I got a green ribbon.
That's awesome.
Congratulations on
that. That's awesome.
And also, yeah. If there's shows you enjoy doing, no reason not to
absolutely,
do them.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, the only reason we did any of the shows that we did was because we enjoyed them.
Yeah.
It didn't even have anything to do with how much money we made
No,
at
it
the
was
show.
The fun factor, mostly. Yeah. Odette said, I could selfishly really do with a weekly dose of Rafi and Klee right now, as our border closure has now been extended until December. Greetings and big love from Tasmania.
Oh, well, big love from us.
Odette, huge love to you. I'm glad you could join us here.
We've made it a point. We changed our recording schedule and some of the editing, so we'll actually be trying to post at least 2 or 3 videos a week.
Yeah, we're on top of it, you guys. Yeah. We're on top of it.
we're on top. It's just crazy.
John!
Oh, thank you, John.
Thank you, John. He said, you guys are the best. Brooke said, the book is fantastic. I sent it as a gift to several rogue artist friends of all genres, musicians, painters, carpenters, and etc. Of course, my copy is next to me. Brooke, that's amazing.
Brooke, thank you for so sharing much. It.
That's so cool.
Oh, I adore Brooke. Adore Brooke. I mean, I adore you all, but I adore Brooke, too.
Robert Vaughn asked, who is your favorite comic? Oh, that's a hard one.
Man, we have so many.
Yeah.
You know, and it depends, Robert. Like, when I was younger, when I was really young, apparently I would listen to records that my dad had in the basement of Richard Pryor. So, like, when I was really young, Richard Pryor was my favorite comic.
You loved him.
And then I loved Eddie Murphy for a long time. And then there was, what's his name? The guy that goes, I'm gonna grow up and kill people.
Oh,
I forget what his name is.
I can't remember his name. I'm terrible.
But Kevin Hart. I love Kevin Hart. Yeah, too.
We love stand up comedy and we love to just laugh. So there's a lot of
stand up comics are one of the group of artists out there that really, really inspire me because they purposefully put themselves out in front of a crowd with material that can potentially suck and they could get booed off the stage.
Yeah, they're doing their R&D and testing in front of a live audience.
Audience, and they keep putting themselves out there and putting themselves out there until they get the act together. And to me, that's amazing. That is amazing.
It's really brave and inspiring. Ev said, we saw the band Kansas live, and at the end of their set, they did the chorus 6 times, so you're allowed to repeat a few pages.
Thank you, Ev.
It's rock and roll, man. Well put. I like that. The Clover artist said Art Station was it, by the way.
Oh, Art Station. Awesome. Awesome.
Samantha said, I think I need to invest in audiobooks. I'm old school. I like physical books, but being dyslexic and wanting things to listen to, I think I should get more audiobooks.
Absolutely.
They're so enjoyable to have on in the studio while you work.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just great.
And you got to think of it this way. Like, any information that you're listening to constantly, you're basically like interpreting that information, and the more information you get, the more it has an effect on your mood. So if you're listening to stuff that's empowering and makes you happy or gives you a different perspective that you think of while you're working in a studio or doing whatever it is you're doing, it really does have an impact on you in a positive way.
Yeah, it's great.
Of course, we listen to things like the Dresden Files too.
Harry Dresden genre
and
books.
Stuff like that. But what also a lot of the stuff we listen to is very, very empowering.
Yeah.
The Cynic Artist, thank you so much. Not a lot, but big thank you. Hey, Ed, thank you.
Let's see. Susie, the Sea Witch.
Hi,
Samantha,
Susie.
Audiobooks improve my life, my commute to and from work, and just daily reading. Since my eyesight is going.
Yeah.
I just love the fact that I could be working on stuff and also enjoying a book.
Yeah.
Because to sit down and read, I was just like not really finding the time for it.
Yep.
Let's see.
Sarah said,
peace and love to all my peeps in Artland.
Peace and love, Sarah.
Abby said, love Eddie Izzard. There's one skit my whole family can quote. It's about being in band in school.
Eddie Izzard. Yes. Eddie Izzard. Yes. Love Eddie Izzard.
Brooke said, there is an autistic lady, can't think of her name, on Netflix, and she is hilarious. Inspirational, too. Brooke, if you think of who she is, shoot us a line.
Yes.
Because we'll check her out.
Absolutely.
Chubby J said, I like
Rodney Dangerfield.
Because he got no respect. Oh, he's classic. He's awesome. SS, as soon as I started my textile art series using the lint collector from my dryer, it stopped making enough lint. I think I need to dry more towels. Your dryer is not being cooperative. I'm sorry. Towels are the best for lint. For sure, for sure. Stutley said, Dresden Files. Dresden Files for the win.
Yep, Dresden Files.
Yeah.
Love it. I'm so happy that he recently came out with the newest book.
It took him forever.
Yeah. So anybody, I got a question on YouTube where somebody asked, like, you know, I've taken like 3 months to work on something. And you got to, like, think about it this way. This author, Jim Butcher, usually came out with a book every year. It took him like almost 2 or 3 years to write the newest book. And everybody, even though I was like, man, I can't believe it's taking him so long, I still, as soon as the book came out, I bought it. So
oh, yeah.
Don't ever be too concerned about taking too long on a project.
It's true. We waited and waited and waited.
Yeah.
Let's see. Shoop said, audiobooks helped me read and work at the same time. I was so torn because I used to be the same way, but it was a game changer for
me. Yeah. Us too. And I like listening to audiobooks when I'm maybe going for a walk.
Yeah.
We listen to a lot of audiobooks.
Shoop said, Hannah Gadsby is the autistic comet.
Okay. Thanks, awesome. Shoop. Thank you.
Jess said, Fortune Feimster is pretty hilarious. Thanks for all the recommendations, y'all. Ev said, oh, I got to check out Hannah. She sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Us too. Chasing Birds, check out Tim Minchin from Australia. Comedy combined with funny songs he makes up.
Oh,
so
that's
funny.
Fun. That's
sounds
fun.
Excellent, too. Brooke said, yes, Hannah Gadsby. Thanks,
yeah.
Shoop.
Yeah, awesome.
Ray, are you thinking of Hannah Gadsby?
Yeah.
Awesome. We're definitely going to check her out.
Yes.
Robert Vaughn said, it's hard to have just one favorite. My favorite seems to change with time. Right now, I'm really into Norm Macdonald.
Yeah,
that's
Norm
true.
McDonald.
It does
yeah.
change over time, depending on where you're at. Brooke said, as are you, Ev. Chasing Birds, audiobooks, rock. Yeah, it's just great. Abby said, fascinating audiobook, The Great Influenza by John Barry about the 1918 flu. Kind of gives some insight into what is going on now, as well as information on the war and medicine that I didn't know.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Books, they're... I was about to make a statement that was so ridiculous. I was going to say, books are interesting. Like, what?
They sure
what
are.
What was about to come out of my mouth?
And with that, good night, everyone.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Books are interesting. It's true.
Oh, that'll be what I get remembered for, you know, in like 40 years. Somebody will be like, yeah, that Rafi guy, he said books are interesting.
Please open the next book that you write with books are interesting.
I am
going to dedicate this one to whoever you dedicate it to.
All right, so it is 8:06. Was Andy Kaufman who you couldn't remember? Yes, I love Andy Kaufman.
I love Andy Kaufman. Oh, man.
Love Andy Kaufman. Yeah, Andy Kaufman was another one that I looked at as far as, like, putting yourself out there in a way that, you know. Thank you, SS.
You are wonderful. Rafi and Klee love you.
Aww,
thank you so much.
Thank you.
Lee Evans is a great British comedian. I almost died seeing him live.
Lee Evans, yes. We've watched Lee Evans. Robin Williams, only human being to make. I love Robin Williams.
Yeah.
It's so many comedians. Like, there's something about people bringing joy and laughter, even talking about subjects that are very, very difficult to talk about.
Absolutely.
I admire that so much. So much.
Comedians are important. They shine a light on stuff and bring people together. Tim!
Tim! Oh, my God. Thank you, Tim.
Thank you so
much,
Tim.
Because following Rafi and Klee is cheaper than therapy. Thank you. Thank you, Tim.
That's awesome.
Night, you crazy kids. Rafi, have you ever tried Nova Color Paint? I ordered some because it's cheap, and I've seen some artists recommend it. I have not. I just recently, I'm actually posting a video about Arteza. We did an Arteza review, so I've tried that. But Nova Color, I definitely have to try that. By the way, you guys, when you watch the Arteza review, it is not a good review. The Arteza product is fine. We are not good at reviewing stuff, which is probably why we will never make money doing reviews on YouTube.
Well, Brooke said, yay, books, which is how you're going to follow up. Books are interesting. Yay, books. This one is dedicated to. I'm going to write that down immediately following this live stream that it can be.
That is what I'm going to be remembered for, and I will definitely put that in my next book.
I just snorted.
Yes, you did. Original SNL, yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, well, let's say goodnight. Oh, God, it's always so hard to say goodbye to you guys.
I know.
I freaking adore you.
You guys are the best, for real.
Look, it's us.
It's us.
It says we adore you.
We do.
Thank you so much for being here, you guys. This was so much freaking fun. I can't thank you enough for giving attention to a nerdy, introverted kid who now spends most of his time in his studio getting his hands covered in paint.
And yeah, and his nerdy, introverted friend and wife who also could say the same, except she doesn't paint.
Yes, I freaking adore you guys. I want a t-shirt that says books are interesting. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do a t-shirt. So
books are interesting. Oh, yay, books.
That's it. That's it. Rafi, what is Rafi? I got to put that on the website in my bio.
I'm dying.
Just so you know what I'm known for, books are interesting. Oh.
Yeah, they are. So
bye, good. Bye, you guys. I adore you.
I love you guys so much.
Yeah.
Adios.
And I love
adios.
You.
Oh. Goodbye.
Books are interesting. Remember that.
Yeah.
All right. How do I end
there
here?
It is.
There it is. Yeah. Bye, you guys.
Bye, everyone.